Vayeshev. The parasha opens, and we're about to read some of the most riveting stories of the entire Bible. However, the beginning does not augur so very positively. Vayeshev Yaakov be'eretz mugurei aviv be'eretz Kanaan. And Yaakov dwelt in the land of the wanderings of his fathers, the land of Canaan. And Rashi immediately says, Bikesh Yaakov leishev b'shalva. Yaakov wanted to live finally with some tranquility. He has gone from pillar to post with all the difficulties vis-a-vis his father and his brother and Lavan. And finally, he wants to achieve some peace, but he cannot because he's confronted with the whole story of Joseph and the difficulties with Joseph and the stories that ultimately cause him so much grief and so much heart sickness. And you know, I've often said, and I believe with all my heart, that of all of the challenges I've had in my life, and I've had considerable ones, I believe that the greatest challenge of all, and the most humbling, is being that of a father, a parent. And in order to truly explain what I mean, and in order to explain to you what Rashi means, that although Yaakov desperately wanted to find tranquility, this was impossible because of Yosef, I'd like to take you away from the cold climates that you're probably living in, and bring you all the way to Pesach in order to interpret this first verse in the book of, in the parasha of Vayeshev. Think of the Pesach Seder. And almost at the very opening of the Pesach Seder comes Karpas, usually translated as a kind of vegetable like parsley. What does Karpas mean? Why do we take it for the beginning of the Seder? And many of the commentaries say we want to get the children to ask, but why ask about this specific thing, and what is Karpas altogether? It's a beautiful Haggadah that was written, the interpretation of it, by Rabbi Shlomo Kluger, already in the early 20th century. And he says something which is amazing. He says that the word Karpas appears just as it is on the Passover Seder, in the beginning of the book of Esther. When the book of Esther describes the magnificent palace of King Ahasuerus, and the palace is reminiscent, certainly the hangings in the palace, the fabrics of the palace are reminiscent of the Holy Temple. For the Jews of Persia, Ahasuerus' palace was their Holy Temple. And it consisted of Hur, Karpas, Utchelet, Achuz, Bechavle, Butz, Argaman. Karpas is a fabric, a very fine cloth. And the pas of Karpas is like the ktone tapasin that Jacob gave to Joseph. The coat or the cloak of many different colors, and the colors kind of in lines, one after the other. And therefore, it was a cloak of many colors. And, says Rav Shlomo Kluger, there are different customs, but a Yemenite custom is to dip the karpas. And the karpas must remind us, because of its name, it's also a vegetable. So to dip the karpas in charoset, which is the color of wine red. Reminiscent of the blood in which the brothers dipped the cloak of many colors, showed it to their father, and said to their father, "This is the cloak that we found. Apparently, your beloved son Joseph was killed by a wild animal." We know that that was not what happened, but the brothers sold Joseph into Egypt. Now, what does this all have to do with the beginning of the Seder? Why does this start our Passover Seder? There's a fascinating statement by the Talmud in the Sechet Brachot, Daf Yud, in which the Gemara says that because of a cloak of many colors, that extra special gift which Jacob gave to Joseph, the history of Jacob's life with his children unwound in such a way as to have caused the Jews to find themselves in Egypt, to be enslaved in Egypt, but ultimately to come out of Egypt. And why did all of this happen? The Gemara says it happened because Jacob played favorites with Joseph in too public a manner. In fact, the very next verse after the Torah tells us that Jacob lived in the land of Canaan, Eile toldot Yaakov, these are the generations of Jacob. Yosef was 17 years old. The generations of Jacob should be all the children, but only Joseph is mentioned because Joseph was his father's clear favorite. And that caused all of the hatred within the family and all the difficulties that led to the families living in Egypt. And the Talmud tells us very clearly that a father must never do that. Now let me just remind you back again to the Passover Seder. Why do we bring this story up at the Passover Seder? Because on the festival of Passover, every father and mother are teachers, trying to impart the Jewish tradition to their children. And there's a warning. It's important for a parent to be an impartial teacher. to try to show the children that they love all their children equally. Not to cause enmity within the family by favoring one above the others. Because Jacob showed that favoritism, the family almost fell apart. Thank God, as the story will unfold, you'll see that at the end it works out. But after much travail, much suffering. It's a warning to parents to show love to all of the children. Because unless the children love their parents, it's going to be very difficult for them to love the tradition of their parents and to love the God of their parents. An important message as we begin the tremendous drama of Jacob and his children. Shabbat Shalom.